Hello everyone, today I am teaching supplementary reader in English of class 10th. Before teaching this lesson, you have to subscribe my channel and like my channel and share to your friends. Okay, now we will see the lesson, second lesson of a supplementary reader of class 10th. So that is the thief's story. In this story, a young boy will be there and that young boy makes friends with Anil. Anil trusts him completely, means Anil believes him completely and employs him, means in this lesson Anil gave a job to that boy. Does the boy betray his trust, means does the boy break his trust with Anil or what? We have to read and understand in this story. Okay, here three questions are there. Read and find out answer for these questions after reading the lesson. So first question, who does I refer to in this story? And second question, what is he, a fairly successful hand at, and what does he get from Anil in return for his work? So we have to find out the answer for these questions. Okay, now we'll see the lesson. I was still a thief when I met Anil. So when he was met Anil, that time he was still a thief. That time that boy was a thief, and I refers to here Skinbone, the author, or thief. Okay, I refers to thief. And though only 15 years, means 15 means 15 years old. That time the boy was 15 years old, and I was an experienced and fairly successful hand. He was saying himself that he was experienced and fairly successful hand. And at what we don't know. So he was telling himself he was a success experienced and fairly successful hand at theft. Anil was watching a wrestling match when I approached him. That time Anil was watching a wrestling match. That is a game, and he was watching. That time that boy went and met Anil. He was about 25. Means Anil was 25 years old. Man, a tall, lean fellow. He was young and he was tall and lean. Lean means thin. And he looked easygoing, kind and simple enough for my purpose. Means that author or Skinbone or the thief thought himself that Anil was simple, kind. Simple and kind. And I hadn't had much luck of late, and thought I might be able to get into the young man's confidence. Then, you look a bit of a wrestler yourself, I said. That boy said to Anil, you look a bit of a wrestler yourself, he told to him. A little flattery helps in making friends. Again he told, a little flattery. Flattery means here excessive and insincere phrase. That is an insincere phrase and given especially to further one's own interest. Okay, then so do you, he replied. Anil replied, so do you. And which put me off for a moment. He stood silent for a while, and because at that time I was rather thin. Because he was that time rather thin. Well, I said modestly. Then he told, modestly means in humble manner he told. Well, I do wrestle a bit. And he told, I do wrestle a bit, he told. What's your name? He asked. Anil asked, what is your name? What's your name? Then he told, Hari Singh. I lied. Means he told, Hari Singh, lied, means he told a lie name. Actually, his name was different and he told in a different name. I took a new name every month. Actually, he was taking new name every month because he was thief. And that kept me ahead of the police and my former employers. That means he was trying to escape from police and former employers. So he was telling lie name every month. Means he was changing his name every month. After this introduction, Anil talked about the well-oiled wrestlers who were grunting, lifting and throwing each other about. Means he talked about grunting, means the wrestlers who were grunting, lifting and throwing well-oiled Then I didn't have much to say. Anil walked away. I followed casually. Means after that, Anil walked away, and even this boy also followed him. Hello again, he said. Again, he said, hello. Hello again. I gave him my most appealing smile. Means he was about to request, I want to work for you. That boy told to Anil, I want to work for you. So that time I said, but I can't pay you. Then Anil told that I can't pay you. You may work for me, but I can't pay you, because he didn't tell any reason. So simply he told, I can't pay you. I can't give you salary for that work, he told. Then after that, what happened? See, here you can see after that. I thought that over for a minute. I thought that for a minute means that time he thought for a while, means to consider an idea or plan carefully before making a decision. Means that is, I thought that over for a minute. Means he thought of for a while and came to a decision, and he told, perhaps I had misjudged my man. Means he was making confusion, that Anil. I had misjudged means confused. I asked, can you feed me? Then that boy asked, if you are not going to pay, if you are not going to give me a job, or if you are not, if I am not able to work for you, or will you give me, can you feed me at least? He asked, that boy asked. Then, can you cook? Anil asked to him, can you cook? Then that boy told, I can cook. I lied again. To Anil, that boy told, I can cook. Again, he told lie only. Actually, he was not going to cook. Actually, he told lie only. If you can cook, then maybe I can feed you. If you are cooking, means maybe it is possible to feed me. I will give you food and you can eat that one. Okay. And he took me to his room over the Jamna Sweet shop, and after that they went to Jamna Sweet shop, and after that he told me I could sleep on the balcony, but the meal I cooked that night must have been terrible, because that time he was not able to do that meal. So he was not able to cook the good food, good tasty food. So it was very terrible, because Anil gave it to a stray dog. Means that Anil gave that food to a stray dog and told me to be off. But I just hung around. Means he was nearby that Anil only that time, and he was going here and there, roaming, smiling in my most appealing way. And he couldn't help laughing. Okay, at that time he didn't show any laugh, smile to that boy. Later he patted me on the head. Means later what he had done, he wished, he patted on his on the head and said, never mind, he would teach me to cook. Means he was going to teach how to cook. Okay. He also taught me to write. He also taught me to write my name and said he would soon teach me to write whole sentences. And also he told, I will teach you to write my name, his name. And he said he would soon teach me to write whole sentences and to add numbers. And I was grateful. So for that, he was thinking that he was grateful to Anil, because he told, I will teach you how to write your name and how to write sentences and how to add the numbers. Everything I will teach you, he told, Anil told. So for that, this thief was very grateful to him. Means he was very thankful to him. I knew that once I could write like an educated man, there would be no limit to what I could achieve. So there is no limit, because he was slowly was becoming very happy, because he wanted to learn, and this time Anil is going to teach him. It was quite pleasant working for Anil. It was quite pleasant for working for Anil. He was getting happy for working for Anil. I made the tea in the morning and then would take my time buying the day's supplies. Means every day he was doing work and he was morning he was preparing that tea in the morning and usually making a profit of about a rupee a day. Means he was usually making a profit of about a rupee a day. I think he knew I made a little money this way, but he did not seem to mind. Means he was making every day 1 rupee, but he did not seem to mind. Here you can see Anil is there. And the boy also is there, and he is teaching how to write his name, and he is writing sentences also, whole sentences also, and he is learning that adding the numbers also. Okay, next we can see here. Next we can see Anil made money by fits and starts. Means he was making money by fitting and starts. He would borrow 1 week. He would borrow 1 week, lend the next. Means here fits and starts means with irregular bus of activity. Means irregular activity he was doing, and he would borrow 1 week, lend the next also. Then he kept worrying about his next check. But as soon as it arrived, he would go out and celebrate. Means when his payment will be happening, now that time he was going out and he was celebrating. It seems he wrote for magazines also. Magazines acquire a way to make a living. Means strange. Queer means strange. One evening, what happened? One evening, he came home with a small bundle of notes. That time he came with a small bundle of notes saying he had just sold a book to a publisher. At night I saw him tuck the money under the mattress. That time he told I sold out a book to a publisher. That time he told at night. I saw him tuck the money under the mattress. Means he tuck means he put the something, means he put that money under the mattress, into the safe convenience place. For a safe and convenience place he kept that money under the mattress, that Anil. I had been working for Anil for almost a month, and apart from cheating on the shopping, means he was very honestly was doing work, that boy, for Anil. Had not done anything in my line of work. I had every opportunity for doing so. Means he was getting opportunity to do that honest work. Anil had given me a key to the door. So Anil had given door key also, key to the door. And I could come and go as I pleased. Means whenever he needed to come, whenever he was he wished to come, that time he may come. So he got the key. He was the most trusting person I had ever met. So Anil was the most trusted person to that boy, and that is why it was so difficult to rob him. So it was too much difficult to rob him, because he was very trusted person. It's easy to rob a greedy man, because he can offer to be robbed. If you are meeting a greedy man, means that time it is very easy to rob him. But it's difficult to rob a careless man. Sometimes he doesn't even notice he is being robbed, and that makes all the pleasure out of the work. Well, It's the time I did some real work. He was doing a real work and he was showing a sympathy. He was showing a very honesty. And then Anil had given me a key over. Sometimes does even notice he is being robbed all the pleasure of work. Well, is the time I did some real work. I told myself I'm out of practice. Then he told out of practice. And if I don't take the money, he will only waste it on his friends. Means if I not taken that money, means he will be wasting that money on his friends. After all, he doesn't even pay. Means after wasting that money to his friends, after that he doesn't pay even that salary to me. And he thought to himself. Then Anil was asleep. Means Anil was in a deep sleep. A beam of moonlight. A beam of moonlight stepped over the balcony. Means a dim light of the moon, because there was a cloudy environment. Environment was very cloudy that time, and stepped over the balcony. That time he stepped over the balcony and fell on the bed. He fell on the bed. I sat up on the floor. That time the boy's lad sat up on the floor. Considering the situation, if I took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. If I took the money, I could catch the 10:30 express to Lucknow. Means if he took the money, he was thinking, if he took the money, he could catch the 10:30 express. Means 10:30 train was there. Means he was thinking about that to reach Lucknow. Slipping out of the blanket, I crept up to the bed. Means he moved slowly towards the bed. Anil was sleeping peacefully. That time Anil was sleeping peacefully. His face was clear and unlined. Means that time his face was very clear and unlined. And even I had more marks more marks were there, and though mine were mostly scars were there on his face. My hand slid under the mattress. So under the mattress, he put his hand searching for the notes. And that time Anil kept that notes, no? So that is why to take that notes, that thief, he was searching, his hands were searching that those notes under the mattress. When I found them, I drove them out without a sound. Very slowly he drove that notes. Anil sighed in his sleep and turned on his side. Means one side from the second side, next side he turned towards me. Means towards him only he turned, and he was sleeping. I was startled and quickly crawled out of the room. Means he was that time he scared a little, whether that Anil is going to wake up or what. So that is why he took that notes and went slowly. Means very fast he went. Not slowly. I was startled. He stared and scared and quickly crawled, means moved, out of the room. When I was on the road, I began to run. When he came on the road, that time he started to run. I had the notes at my waist, on his waist. That those notes were there, which he took from the under the mattress of Anil, and held there by the string of my pyjams. I slowed down to a walk and counted the notes. He counted those notes, how many he had taken. There were 600 rupees in 50s, means 50 rupees notes were there, means totally 600 rupees notes were there, means how many 50 notes he had taken? 12. Okay, 600 rupees were there. I could live like an oil rich Arab for a week or two. He was living like oil rich Arab. Then can see here. When I reached the station, I did not stop at the ticket office. Means when he reached the station, that time he did not stop nearby that ticket office. Why? Because I had never bought a ticket in my life. Because he don't know how to take the ticket, and he don't know addition and subtraction. So that is why he was stopped at a ticket office, and I had never bought a ticket in my life. He was thinking himself, and he stopped at the ticket office, but dashed straight to the platform. Then he went to the towards the platform. The Lucknow Express was just moving out, means it was moving out just. Okay, the train had still to pick up speed, means it was about to take the speed, and I should have been able to jump into one of the carriages, but I hesitated. He was about to jump, but he hesitated for some reason I can't explain. Means he was about to escape, but he was helpless. For some reason, he has not jumped. I can't jump. I can't explain the reason. He thought himself why he has not jumped, and I lost the chance to get away. Means that train went towards the next Lucknow, and he lost that opportunity to get away from that place. When the train had gone, I found myself standing alone on the deserted platform. Means here, deserted means empty platform. Empty platform. He was only. He was alone there on that platform. I had no idea where to spend the night. He was not getting the idea where to sleep at that night. I had no friends also, believing that friends were more trouble than help. And I did not want to make anyone curious by staying at one of the small hotels near the stations. And the only person I knew really well was the man I had robbed. So from where he took that 600 rupees, no, from Anil. So that person was very well, and he was believing that person only. Leaving the station, I walked slowly through the bazaar, and after that he left the station, and he was walking through the bazaar, and he was moving. In my short career as a thief, I had made a study of men's faces when they had lost their goods. He met many persons, and he studied the faces also about the character of those men. The greedy man showed fear. Means in his experience, he is thinking himself that how the men will be there, how the men will be there, and how their facial expressions will be there. The greedy man usually he will be showing fear. And the rich man showed anger, the poor man showed acceptance to him. But I knew that Anil's face, he knew that Anil's face very well when he discovered the theft. He was knowing I'm a theft also. He would show only a touch of a sadness, not for the loss of money. Means he was. Not for the loss of money, he was not showing that kind of expression, but for the loss of trust. If he met once again that Anil, he will be showing the loss of not the loss of money or sadness. He will be showing on his face loss of trust on him. I found myself in the maidan. Maidan means open ground, open place. I sat down on a bench. On a bench, that boy sat and he was thinking himself. The night was chilly, means it was cold. It was early. It was early November. It was early November, and a light drizzle added to my discomfort. Means that time a dim light was there, and it was discomfort to that boy. Soon it was raining quite heavily. So it was raining quite heavily that time. My shirt and pajamas were there, no, so stuck to my skin because of rain. And a cold wind blew the rain across my face, across his face. Cold wind also blowing. Then I went back to the bazaar. So because he came from bazaar, no, so now he was moving towards the bazaar, and sat down in the shelter of the clock tower because he was needed the shelter. It was raining heavily, so he sat down under the shelter of that clock tower. The clock tower, that clock showed midnight. That time that clock was there, no, on the tower, it showed midnight. I felt for the notes. He was feeling, he was thinking about those notes. They were damp from the rain, means they were getting wet. Damp means wet from the rainwater. Anil's money in the morning, he would probably have given me 2 or 3 rupees to go to the cinema. Means Anil's money in the morning, he would probably have given me 2 or 3 or 2 rupees to go to the cinema. He was he would give 2 or 3 rupees to go to cinema, but now he has 600 rupees, and that also robbed money from the Anil, a trusted man. If I return to meet him, then how his expression will be there? He was thinking about that, so that is why he left that train also. But now I had it all. Now I had it all. I couldn't cook his meals, run to the bazaar, or learn to write whole sentences anymore. He was thinking himself. I had forgotten about them in the excitement, of the theft. Whole sentences I knew could one day bring me more than a few hundred rupees, he was thinking. It was a simple matter to steal. Actually, the stealing is, you know, that is simple matter, and sometimes what will happen, just as simple to be caught. Means how much it is very simple to steal, no, that much simply only we will be catching by the police and former employers also. But to be a really big man, a clever and a respected man, was something else. I should go back to Anil. So he was thinking about Anil, and he was decided himself to go back to meet Anil. I told myself, if only to learn to read and write. For reading purpose and writing purpose, I had to go to Anil. Further, he thought himself, and I hurried back to the room, feeling very nervous. He was feeling very nervous, and for it is much easier to steal something than to return it undetected. Means how much it is very easy to steal from somebody. Now it is very difficult to return it, right? I opened the door quietly, very slowly he opened without making sound, very silently he opened door, and then stood in the doorway in clouded moonlight. That a dim light was there. There he stood, and Anil was still asleep. Means Anil was in deep sleep, and I crept to the head of the bed. Towards the head of the bed, he moved very slowly, he crawled, and My hand came up with the notes, and he took the notes from his vest. I felt his breath on my hand, and I remained still for a minute. For a minute, he stood again. Then my hand found the edge of the mattress. He found the edge of the mattress in that dim light and slipped under it with the notes, and he kept those notes there only. I awoke late next morning. He woke up very lately to find that Anil had already made the tea. So that time Anil had already, he didn't know about this matter. This boy robbed his money. Again he went to railway station. He wanted to escape from that place, but he missed the train, and after that he came back and he kept that 600 rupees under the mattress. That time morning Anil had prepared a tea. He stretched out his hand towards me. There was a 50 rupee note between his fingers. He stretched out his hand towards me. So that time what happened, there was a 50 rupee note between his finger. When he stretched his hand towards him, that time 50 rupees note was there. My heart sank. I thought I had been discovered. He thought that he had been caught by him. I made some money yesterday. And then he explained that one. Yesterday I got some money. I made some money. He explained it. Now you will be paid regularly. He told, now onwards I will be giving you your salary. Regularly I will give your salary, your payment I will give you. You will be paid regularly, he told. Anil told, because he was a trusted man. My spirits rose. His spirits felt very happy. But when I took the note, I saw it was still wet from the night's rain. When he took that 50 rupees note from his finger, no, Anil's finger, that time he felt that it was still wet because he only kept under the mattress. Today we will start writing sentences. Again he told, Anil told, today we'll start writing sentences, he told. He knew, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. He knew that one, I only robbed that money, and I came back and I kept that money under the mattress. He knew everything, but neither his lips shows any angry showed anything. I smiled at Anil in my most appealing way, and the smile came by itself without any effort. Lesson is written by Ruskin Bond. So he is the thief beginning. So here he has written his story only. So I means here refer. So you have to find out the answer for the beginning questions, three questions, and after that you have to read the glossary words. You can see here glossary of flattery means insincere phrase. Modesty means without boasting, in a humble way. And grunting means making low guttural sounds. Appealing means attractive. Unlined means here showing no sign of worry or anxiety. Okay, here I hope you understood the lesson. Keep subscribing my channel. You will get videos we will be uploading in this channel, you will get regularly videos. So keep subscribing, sharing and liking. Thank you everyone.